longitudes. Now, longitudes always run north to south. So what happens at the pole? At the pole, they start to converge or meet. And therefore, we say that these meridians join towards the pole and they are farthest towards the equator, closest near the pole. Now, when I say closest near the pole, that means the difference between the two meridians that are there is zero. However, at the equator, the distance is maximum. It's around 111.3 kilometers. At nearly 45 degrees, if we see, the distance is nearly 79 kilometers, drastically reducing further north. And that's how we have the meridians that are there. Now, these help in understanding the location, the direction. So wherever you have the intersection of latitudes and longitudes, I can have the exact place on the earth that could be embarked. Similarly, whenever we are talking about, be it latitude or longitude, we are talking about degrees. 1 degree is further subdivided into 60 minutes and 1 minute is further subdivided into 60 seconds. And this is the unit that we use to subdivide these areas. So a whole rotation takes 24 hours. So in 24 hours, how much does Earth move is 360 degrees. So that means what we are trying to understand is the calculation for 1 hour, and then the calculation for 1 hour, we could further reduce it to one degree. Okay, so 1 degree, we have 4 minutes that is calculated. And that's how we understand the calculations that would be done later on, or the problems that we would be solving later on. Now, understanding how do we draw the longitudes. Drawing the longitude is pretty simple. Take the north hemisphere or the south hemisphere, not the equatorial region. So, under a latitude, we took the equatorial region. Under drawing a longitude, we would take the north hemisphere or the south hemisphere. Now, taking the north hemisphere or the north pole, from the north pole, I mark 45 degrees and that gives me 45 degrees east and west, and based on which I have the meridians that would be drawn. So, it's the angular distance. Remember, it's an angular distance east or west of prime meridian, which is the 0 degree line, or the Greenwich meridian as it is already called as. Opposite to the Greenwich meridian, you have 180 degree line, which is also known as the international date line, and it is at that point the date shifts. So shift in the day is seen at the international date line, directly opposite to the 0 degree or the Greenwich or prime meridian as it is called as. So the angular distance east and west of the prime meridian, so the angular distance east and west of the prime meridian is what is calculated under longitudes. Angular distance north and south of equator as the latitude.